Hey there everyone, my name is Atesh and I make coding videos just like the one you're watching here. So in case you're new here, go ahead and subscribe the channel and let's continue our series of building the SaaS. So in the last video, we did a whole lot of work in just setting up the middleware. So in this video, we'll take a small detour and we'll make sure that the login and signup process is comparatively easy. We definitely will come back onto the login and signup so that I can walk you through with the customization of it. But right now with this SaaS, the focus is more on utilizing the power of the Cloudinary and the AI and how to build the whole structure, not just with the auth. So we'll take a small, easiest step with this one. But again, there's not going to be no change at all in this one. So let me just share the screen and how we're going to do with this one. So let's just close everything up here. We can go on to the Clerk, and we can see in the Clerk we have build your own sign in and sign up pages. It's not customized sign up, but it definitely works the way how they want it to work. And all you can do is you can come here and just create a route like this, which is sign up slash and this page.tsx, and just have to add this. And this automatically works everything just like the magic. So let me just go ahead and set this one up. Now, in order to set this up, what we're going to do is we're going to have this app. So everything goes inside the app. I'll just right click on this, create a new folder, and I'll use the parentheses. When you use parentheses, this route is not being fetched on the Next.js. It's just grouping of the routes. So I'm going to call this one as auth so that I know exactly that all of my routes and folders and everything is inside that. Now I can go back and create an app, which is sign up, and then this whole page.tsx I need to make. So I'll just copy this and we'll try to create a new file. And we'll paste it up there. Hopefully this will create the folders and structure for me. And yes, it does. And yes, it does. Just exactly they want. So this is a catch-all route in which all of the routes are being catched for the signup related process. And now you can just go ahead and copy the code and paste it up here. So that's it. You can borrow this signup component from the Clerk Next.js and it just loads that up automatically. We'll come back onto this one in this because we have to make a slight modification since we have taken the detour, which is sign dash up. But no worries, we can just fix that up. And we'll need one more similar with folder, this one, which is sign in and this page.tsx. So again, copy this and let's go ahead inside the auth and create a new file. And let's just paste this one. And there we go. So now we have sign up and sign in. Sign in borrows the sign in component, copy and paste this, and there we go. So the route that it creates is sign dash in and sign dash up. And the easy thing for us is I can go into the middleware and can say this is sign dash in and this is sign dash up. And the advantage of this not scattered around everywhere is I can just make a couple of changes here and just work with that. So this one can be simply sign dash in, and I think that's it. That's it. That is it. All it takes. We can come back here and can make our own routes in this one. Probably I'll share that as well. But I think this is all that is required. Let's read more of the documentation part of it. Now we have to update the environment variables. Environment variable definitely need this sign up and sign in URL. So we'll just copy this and we'll just create the new files. And again, this file is env.local. So I'll talk about these later on. Right now, let's just create this one. Oh, we already have env.local in which we can just go ahead and copy paste this. This is publishable key, but this time we'll say that, hey, this is our routes. All the things are up here. All right, what else do you need? We have the API keys. We don't have the API keys. So let's go back here. These are the keys. So let's just go ahead and copy this and we'll paste them up here. We'll anyways delete these keys. So not gonna be useful much for you. Anyways, you can just go ahead and have your own keys. That's it, I guess. And we can have the users up here. We probably have some users from the old past of these ones. So we can just delete this user. And now in the users and authentication, you can just check for email, whatever you need. Email, you need phone number, you need usernames, password, email verification code. You want to get that. You want to allow user for social connection. I guess one is by default allowed. Google, which is shared credential, but hey, it works, it works. So let's just go ahead and try to see that whether it works or it doesn't work. So we're going to go ahead and say npm run dev, and we can just go ahead. Environment is loading is env local. I really like this message. It makes it very clear that which environment variable I'm actually loading up, which one is in the present and working. In a production grade application, there are many such applications. So this is the home route and this is okay. Now let's just say if I go ahead and see slash home is not gonna be working, we don't have that. Let's try dash sign in. If I go ahead and sign in, it doesn't look really that well because we haven't customized it. But yeah, it is there, it works. We can probably customize it a little bit. This one was sign in. We'll work on the sign up as well. So auth, sign up, and page. We probably can align it center and we can probably have a layout as well. What do you want, how this should be worked? Probably we should talk about this later on. Right now, let's focus on the functionality part. So now we have this. Now we need a couple of more routes to actually verify whether things are going good or not good or how they are working. Let's close this and create another of this folder, which is collection folder. I'm gonna call this one as app, because whole of my rest of the app is gonna be up here. And we can just go ahead and create a couple of routes up here. The first one, let's go ahead and create a home. So we're gonna just open this up, right click, new folder, and we're gonna call this one as home. This is my home route. Now in each of these routes that you create in Next.js, you need to have a page.tsx, and we'll be just saying home there, nothing else as of now. Right click, new file, and we're gonna call this one as page.tsx. Now, tsx is good. And we can just go ahead and say RFCE. I don't have that extension, so let me just go ahead and quickly grab that extension. All right, so here is the extension, ES7. I think this is the one that I've been using. So I can just go ahead and open this up, install. Should be okay without reloading the application. And I can just go ahead and hit the tab that I want the view of the Explorer again. So let's go there. And now probably I can say RFCE, React Functional Export, page. Let's call this one as home. Home is good enough. And we'll just go like that. All right, so at least we have a home page. We don't have much saying in this, but let's just say if we have more of these pages like social share, so we can just right click and create a new folder. We're gonna call this one as social-share. Inside that, we need a page.tsx. And let's just say RFCE, there we go. This one is going to be social share, there we go. Now the thing is, how much of these pages are we able to access? Sign in is good enough, and we should be able to access the home. There we go. And what about social-share? It's redirecting me to the sign in. So our middleware is working fine. We definitely will come back here and I'll walk you through how you can have a customized solution like this one. This is surely doable. We did it up here, I'll walk you through. But I think this will actually detour us from too much in the UI part. I wanted to focus more on the functionality part first. So there we go. Now let's go ahead and try login. I'll probably log in with my existing email. And unable to complete action on time. This problem persists. Please contact support. Looks like the issue is here. So all the issue is probably up here, or probably I don't have proper. All right, so let me go ahead into user. Oh, this is sign in, I guess. Yep, this is sign in. I should be in the sign up. All right, so this is sign up. Let's try with the Google. And this should be sign up. So already it logs in with my existing browser wherever I'm logged in with the Google. And now I'm able to access home. And if I go ahead and try social share, I'm able to access the social share. So at least the UI part and what all needed I for this authentication is all done. I can focus now on functionality part, and we have something on the pages. So let's just go ahead, since we are already here in the auth part, let's just create one more, couple of more files, and we'll just sort this out. We have one more route in this one. Let's create a new folder. This one is going to be video upload. Video dash upload. And again, page.tsx. I can do it much faster with the keyboard, but I'll still do it with the mouse. Video upload. There we go. So we have three routes at least, and later on, probably we can create a layout so that it looks good, but doesn't really matter. In the route, we can just check what's happening, what's not happening, and all of that. Again, super happy with what is the progress that we have made. All right, what next we have? Now, in the next video, we can just close all of this and we can create one more folder here, which can be API, and can focus more on the API part first, because that's where the majority of things happen. That's where majority of the Cloudinary talks happen. So let's just right click on this one, create a new folder on the API, and that's it. So what we can do now? Now, in the next video, what we can do is we can focus more on the API understandability of how do we take a file upload and send it to the Cloudinary and get a response back. How do we send the video to them and how we get the response back, how that all the things happen. So that is going to be taken care of in the API part in itself. And the home API as well, in which we just make a query that how many videos you have, we return that videos back. We also need to set up the Prisma as well, so that without the Prisma, we cannot upload the videos because we need to take care that who is the user who's uploading the videos. So that also need to be taken care of. We'll see what we are going to pick up in the next video, either the Prisma or the API route of this. So both are equally good. You'll be enjoying both of them. That's it for this video. Let's catch up in the next one.